this out.
Welcome back, everybody, here to our wonderful World of the Dota 2 Champions League. I am Toby1, bringing you your second series of the night, second game of the night from our only series of the evening. It's Fnatic versus Power Rangers, where Fnatic are keeping their hopes alive to completely upset and turn topsy-turvy into the group stage for the European division. It's all so close, it can just come down to one or two victories that separate these teams. And right now, Fnatic looking pretty damn good after game number one, never losing their gold or experience advantage. Of course, there were a couple of team fights where it kind of kicked back in again, but still, they held strong, they held true, and Harney's Morphling did a hell of a lot of work to carry him there. But it's also more than that. The coordination from Fnatic, while it could have been a little bit off in some of the engagements, there was a free kill from the Centaur that ended up happening as well. And like, maybe not the greatest jump onto that T1 tower in the middle lane, but as a unit, they seemed to really gel it around that 20-minute mark, and they functioned a lot better together once Harney was like, you know what, somehow I've got myself this amazing E-Blade. How about we get our combo here, here, and here? And then you saw the movement from Arise when he came to work with Harney, and then they moved together as a good squad in through the bottom, and they got their chain abilities off really nicely, and that just worked for him. That just worked for him. So Fnatic, we'll go on a game number two with a bit of a high. Power Rangers should do what they always do. Don't give a crap about the last game. Think about this game and just beat the living crap out of the enemy. That's the goal right now. They tried to do something a little bit different. They tried to run a Spectre while having some aggressive points to their lineup, but it just didn't work, and it didn't really feel, again, like them. The Lutrak and the SD didn't really do enough when they rotated as well. And it was just a little bit too passive and sit-back kind of stylish. So, Fnatic, they started off with the Chrono Void. So, nice from them. That's going to be their combination here. They already took out the Skywrath as well as the Batrider, however. So, I'm interested to see what they want to do from that. You actually seen Cheshire Cat banning at the Brewmaster because of that. Considering you see a Skywrath ban, you're probably going to be sitting there going, I think I know what they're going to do. Which would have been the Brewmaster, which is why that's been banned out in the first set. But with the Faceless Void being picked up, Fnatic aren't really locked into anything. In fact, they can lock them into it. And an Ogre Magi comes up from Power Rangers. So expect a rather aggressive lane coming out from PR. Ogre Magi, of course, we saw him burst into the scene with the latest patch. He came out 3 days actually after was the first game I got to cast of Ogre Magi. 3 days after the patch. And he was just... it was brutal. With the real buff ups he's had to his ultimate... with the level 2 ultimate, you basically have your old level 3, I believe Mirana. It is. Actually, I think at level 1, you had the level 2 ultimate, is
Fnatic,
the way it is.
Turn to ban.
And then that kind of burst and surgence in power, potentially, which the generator could give to you, is just so strong that you just want to go with it. You just want to pick up this hero, and then you buff up all your other guys. So everyone's walking around with this bonus movement speed. It's just like this ability right here, the Bloodlust. So 16% bonus movement speed, Fnatic, and your attack speed up by 50 as well. You pump this into a Razor, if you can steal out some good damage, you have yourself a winner right there. Of course, though, he still needs to work in the lanes. And that's where Ogre Magi can kind of fall off. His mana cost is rather high for his abilities. He can trigger his stun, he can trigger his ignite. But all of this stuff together, remaining. It just... it costs a lot for what you want to achieve.
Radiant,
and that's where I'm
ban.
Not quite sure if this is really going to work for him. And I'm looking at something like now from Fnatic, where they can just turn and push into the Ogre Magi instead. So if they get like a Mirana pickup, which they have, to go with the Bane, which I will assume will be Cheshire Cat's second ban out right remaining. Now, because it's a great controller up against the Razor and the Ogre Magi. Just think, he's more worried about the
Radiant
Ember Spirit.
Team pick.
I wouldn't have been... well, in that case, is he not going for any more control than an Ogre Magi? Because Fnatic could get away with dual lanes right now. In fact, they can get away with more depending on who the offlaner from Power Rangers is. Because if you want, you can still run an aggro tri lane with that Mirana. You just need the heroes that are going to work with
10 seconds remaining.
And that's where maybe you could be picking up something like... you could always go for something like a Rubick. 5 seconds remaining. But you want to have more damage inside the Chronosphere. And you don't need to risk it with that. Like, just the Bane is enough for your control hold support hero that you'll be searching for. An ancient apparition as well.
Fnatic's turn.
The Ogre Magi stun as well as the ancient apparition cold feet. Somehow I don't think that's the combo they're searching for. We're looking at Vortex, we're looking at Chilling Touch and straight up damage. And this has to be an aggro tri lane. They'll need to have a stunner to go with this lineup beyond that of the Ogre Magi. What they have right now, either that or is burst damage style hero from Power Rangers. Because I don't think PR just want to sit back and just...
10 seconds remaining.
Enjoy the flowers. It's not really what they should be looking at.
Remaining.
And it'll be an Enigma. So Fnatic, they'll wait
Radiant
it out.
Team pick.
They'll either run the face of the void as a safe lane hero. And just pick themselves up an offlane hero they believe can survive up against this. Maybe even bring that new bounty hunter into play. Once he gets detected, things can go really bad for him. But at the same time, having track gold in a meta like this, hell yes.
Turn to pick.
And a VS. It's aggro tri lane. It's full aggro tri lane. That VS is a core in this. Ogre Magi, Ancient Apparition will be buffing her up. As well as themselves. The Razor for the middle lane, and then someone else for the off lane. Fnatic, actually, at this point, depending who that last pick is up for the Power Rangers, I almost want to see Enigma go in towards the mid up against the Razor. Won't be as great once he gets the plasma fill up into higher levels, though. Or you can run him as an offlaner. I know Ryze wants to take the Enigma because he's a fantastic jungle player. But with this Fnatic lineup, it's so dangerous to go up against this. Unless... That's why, like, I want the Enigma to go into,
Radiant team ban.
Into a support role, into a core role here. Because it frees up the secondary support. So you can have Mirana as a core, the Witch Doctor with him, and then somebody else that can also, like, push him back in the lane. Like, that's got to be the goal right now.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
But the last ban's now to come out. Power Rangers... It's so difficult to ban Reserve against this because you could just assume it's going to be a like a Faceless Void offlane, a Mirana safe lane with a Witch Doctor, so you still have like a leap out. Because you've only got 2 stuns on that top lane. It's the VS, it's the Ogre Magi. And with Voodoo Restoration, at level 1 it won't be as much, but the Paralyzing Cast could buy you that space to get yourself away. And that'll buy you the time to leap and disjoint. If you disjoint the VS done, then you're good. And they ban out the Magnus,
Fnatic's
thinking that'll be the final one, which would... push either Mirana, Faceless Void into a core role, or the Enigma himself. So Fnatic's final ban now here. They're going to look towards a safe laner. So whoever they want to run as their off laner, they should ban out a good counter hero against that hero right now. So there's no way for us to really predict what they would want to run here unless you just know Power Rangers that well. Like you could say, wow, bad, Timbersaw. But that's probably not going to be the greatest hero to go up against... Enigma or Void and a Witch Doctor. There's too much control on him. He won't be able to chain freely around. So 43 seconds now on the countdown for Fnatic. Who do they really want? Who are they even running in the lane? And they ban an Allegiant Commander. Someone rather tanky, wouldn't care about too much harassment damage, and also is a nice one-on-one initiator. Huh. I'm actually even wondering in this game if it's worthwhile for Fnatic to... they could pick up their own Timbersaw in this game. Because where's your control? It's just not there. You want to throw in, potentially... Well, you're not going to get to double shark him with this lineup from Fnatic. Not unless you go late game, and that's pretty risky for them. And they should get a lone druid.
Fnatic's
so, Lone Druid against the offlaner Fnatic, the aggro trial, and then Razor in the mid. Nice combination. Which means you can't really run that Enigma on the offlaner. Like, he can deny and keep the creep wave back, but the Lone Druid will gain the advantage there. And you're already battening down the hatches to try and survive up against that top lane, unless you get killed heroes. So, murderous intent style heroes. Personally, I'd actually like to see the Faceless Void just sack the top lane. Have the Enigma in the jungle. You might have a little bit of problems with the VS and the Ancient Apparition, but just put some down some nice vision wards, and you should be okay. And the Wish Doctor just pulls for the top lane. Or you could push the Enigma in towards the middle lane, have a Mirana Bane off lane up against the Lone Druid, and then the Witch Doctor and Faceless Void up on the top lane. Don't need to have the Enigma in the jungle. So Fnatic do have options here. It's just depending which path they want to walk down. Now they're running out of time to decide here, honey. That Lone Druid would have actually been a really nice last pickup for them, but they go for the Quap. So mid-solo hero. And be taken by a Ryze. Technically, he could use that Queen of Pain on the offlane to go up against the Lone Druid. It's come with me, it's Enigma. Alright, so we are looking at a, wait, Harney on the Mirana? Yeah, so it's Enigma Jungle, Witch Doctor support, Harney's Mirana, so safe lane, and what, Void in the mid lane up against the Razor? Have to pull in some consumables early on. But if you can just get that Stout Shield into a PMS very early on too, he should be okay. So I'm kind of seeing the upsides of both of these lineups. Who really gets the upper hand is just going to come down to play during the laning phase. That's what this really all just comes down to.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
So let's see how effective that Quap is going to be. Up against the VS and the AA, she could do a lot of damage there. If this Queen of Pain's capable of farming up a very early Blink Dagger, then anything is really possible. You're gonna need to get the space on the Quap. Like, you can't just have a lane that isn't one. The Quap's actually quite good up against the Razor, because you're able to harass him down. And what the hell set are they running on this Ogre Magi? It's just mainly the cloak on the back. How very pretty. We got the champion's belt from the International. The belly guard. The mantle, so yeah, and... Wait, is that his back piece? That's the belt, that's the back piece. The mantle of ancestral luck. That's what that thing is. Where's the belt? Can we get a belt shot? Let's get a belt shot. Camera, work for me. There you go, there's that belly. Watch it wobble. Alright, into the lanes. So, no surprise, aggro trial lane coming out. They'll have everybody moving up towards the north because they want to establish ward dominance on this top lane. As far as Fnatic go, they've got a Ryze on the off lane as the Queen of Pain. Now, she'll be going one-on-one with Shashlo, which is a fantastic lane for her. The bear will be a little bit annoying with an Orb of Venom early on, more than likely from the bear, of course. That's actually not confirmed because the bear is currently walking up towards the top lane. But, you pick one up. He's got, 350 gold. It's going to be an Orb of Venom bear first, unless he feels he can rush a hand of Midas. But the Queen of Pain with the Shadow Strike directly in towards Lone Druid is going to push him out of the lane. And that's where you get your advantage from. Ace will be the middle lane Faceless Void. That puts Ryze up on the top lane, which the bear will now scout him out. And Harney's also over here. Because they saw the Lone Druid bear, they may consider that it's just a Lone Druid off lane. And a Razor safe lane or a VS safe lane. But the VS safe lane makes no sense. If you're running an Ogre Magi, an AA, and a VS, you want to be aggressive. It's just that simple. You want to be murdering people with this lineup. I leave one aggressive observer ward up there. That's going to look for where the Enigma is. Right now, come with me. I think he wants to go to Radiant Jungle.
The battle begins.
The Radiant did leave an observer ward down here, so they can also watch the bottom rune, which has now been taken. Bounty by Cheshire Cat, and it'll be a, would you move your fat ass? What is he on top of? You literally can't. Did he already take it? No, bounty rune. What do you? It's a haste rune. Should have actually glowed a bigger color than red. Yeah, just blended in with his fat ass. Yeah. So a haste rune for him. But they get scouted up by the observer ward. So we just sick as well as J4. It's very obvious what's going on here. And then she gave it to the one guy who doesn't have the stun. Now Ryze can see perfectly over the tree line. Doesn't want to attack because if he does do so, he reveals the fact the ward's going to be there. Ryze lost. Okay, they actually switched their lanes up here. The Enigma's inside the jungle, and come with me, can lend a hand. But Shashlo actually moved towards the middle lane to go up against the Faceless Void. So the CS there should be fairly even. The bear's going to be more of a nuisance once you see Sharshlo hit level 5. Because there's no orb of venom on this bear. So I got a funny feeling Sharshlo really is looking for the double Midas build. Top lane J4. Still into Hani. They'll pop off the chilling touch, but Hani just knew he'd leap himself away. And with a bit of a paralyzing cask, they'll return... Okay, not all the damage, because there's still a lot of damage there, Hani. That's the chilling touch still having its effect. They do some nice chip damage into Hani. But the fact they can't contest the Enigma at all, that's more problematic right now for Power Rangers. The Enigma's just going to get free farm inside that jungle. So whatever they are missing out on this top lane, like, sure, Hani won't get a lot of CS. As long as they don't die, then Fnatic should come out on top of this trade-off, especially if they can do this. There's a Malifasun leveled up. Arise also with a Shadow Strike. The Conversion Army is here, but it is timing out. The Blink down. They need a lot more damage than what they've already got. The Shadow Strike's about to wear off, but I think that actually it is enough. That's a big kill right there for Arise to claim that one. Coldly reveals himself. And now even an arrow onto the, well, right in front of the bounty rune. But this means they're going to bring more people down here. Once they realize the Enigma is capable of doing this, Arise obviously gets a lot more levels too, up to a second level up in that Shadow Strike for the Queen of Pain. So it's a lot more chip damage now coming into Cheshire Cat, who can't afford to run a bottle into this lane. They'll come up towards the top lane. Now the Vortex, the first stun, the Chilling Touch with the Magic Missile. Hani leaps himself away, but that last attack from J4 hits hard. So I'll have that affect the Chilling Touch on him. Not much. So it goes 1-1 as the trade-off. There's also another reason too why Quap works so well up against Razor. You just blink yourself away from all the damage deal. And then just harass him back with the Shadow Strike, which means you don't even need to stay in range. And you're primarily slowing down the Razor too. So you win on the movement part of it. Now the Faceless Boy is falling behind a little bit in these levels now. In the farm. Sitting 13-2 up against a 9-7. Actually, Ace is ahead in levels for the moment, but that's because he's also got... Actually, he's got another creep wave coming in too. Okay, he wins on levels. That seems to win on farm as well. Now, the Orb of Venom is now in that bear. It's all about the harassment. Come on, me's up to level 4.5 inside the jungle. Bringing his army of conversions over. These guys will survive for a little bit longer. But the chance of them getting another kill right now... Cheshire Cat needs to come up a lot further. And there's no Midnight Pulse, so you could send the army of conversions in behind the tower. But it'll just end up feeding more than anything else. That's a big line being drawn out there by Ogre Mishai. I wonder if this is a... Can we try and get a kill here and then just get ourselves out, like, on bottom lane? Kami shows himself again. J4 just TP to the lane. But it's a level 2 Ogre Mishai. This isn't going to be enough. And if Kami needs to, he can just stay in the lane. This guy's running a Sol Ring now. He can just keep converting his own creep wave and dragging him over to the ancient area. Denied. That's if he doesn't want to take up the lane space. And Cheshire Cat, this is not a safe place for him. Little intel tread switch so he can try and get up to another point up, another Shadow Strike hip. But Arise, actually, he's in more trouble. This is a regeneration rune for the Ogre Mishai.
Too bad.
But the switch is pressed pretty quickly. He's trying to battle against Cheshire Cat, then blinks at the tree line. They know where he is. And in fact, now they're going to actually immolate him. He tried a basic attack into Cheshire Cat. He was still 84 points of damage. Now, while in the middle lane, Lone Druid. Not enough damage. Even with the conversion attacking, they couldn't finish the job there. Just before the Chrono was up and ready to go. So Fnatic losing a little bit of control in this game. So Arise now does return to the bottom lane. This time with not really, really low life. You might consider a blink to scream. In fact, you just see him just tap the blink for a moment. And he can see Cheshire Cat perfectly. That Observer Ward on the other side of the tree line is giving him all the sign he needs. He just wants to get the Shadow Strike in. That was his only goal there. The Shadow Strike was his only goal. He wants Razor to be ticking down. Especially when he's still walking around with some extra mana. And not regenerating. So if you're full up. Like, you wanna be able to just always be ticking him down. But again, another rotation coming in from the Ogre Mishai. The Observer Ward's watching for this. And Arise, he's only got one point up with a blink. Blinked at the tree line. This time at least we had a sever. The attachment as Arise. He's trying to hide the tree line, but that's not gonna work for him. Again, being immolated up.
No.
Oh, sorry, I should say ignited. Well, Ace, Chrono, Committal. He got entangled though, so it's wasting a lot of the chrono time. And he wants a time lock. Actually, comes up to the high ground for this, and that's a big waste from Ace. Trying to force the issue on Sharshlo, but he triggered the chrono after he got entangled. So because of that, he knew he had to stand where he was. He couldn't reach the hero to attack, so he had to wait it out. This is not what they wanted to have happen. And now there's a bit of confusion in the lane, because we've got both Arise and Ace trying to farm up the lane. Like, even look at the way they're moving. It's like watching a pub game at the moment. Who gets more farm here? Either that or they're trying to force in towards the tower, but you got no DD rune. In fact, you're even giving away the runes because of this. Ace with this bottle, he'll come down, but because he's stuck around, trying to steal a little bit of the farm, he's going to get nothing. Next on the top lane, this Vengeful Spirit's going to take a fall. The army conversions won't stay alive here for Come With Me.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Actually, they're not ready to push. Their own creep wave is coming in now with the catapults. They can push on the back of that, but the timing's a little off. This is not the Fnatic which we saw halfway through last game. Synergizing nicely, all the rotations seem to have a lot of purpose. In this game, it's kind of a bit more of a little bit of a slap and tickle kind of thing. It's funny at first, and then you're like, well, okay, this is actually seriously bad for your health. And Ace. Now he's up on this bottom lane up against Razor. Probably the matchup which he wanted to have from the very, very start. But in the middle lane, so he could rely on the bottle and the runes to keep him in control. But then when Power Rangers moved Cheshire Cat to this bottom lane, it just didn't work as well. And Ace, he's getting his chrono back off cooldown in a moment. So that's the reason why he's back inside the lane. Because he knows Razor can't kill him before the chrono's off cooldown. And that gives Arise more of a control in this mid. Around the same time as normally you try and move a support into the mid lane to soak up some experience. So the lane rotation from Fnatic is good. As Lone Druid takes the Bounty Rune over on the bat. And the Regeneration Rune taken again by Ogre Mishai. That's two for this game right now. And Arise is backing up. So notice two Arise doing something very uncommon. With his Intel Treads, he's capable of actually using everything. But he leveled up Sonic Wave at level 7. This is after going 2 points up in the Shadow Strike. Normally you'd wait till level 8 before you do such a thing.
You are simply
because your stream's just more
worthy.
Effective in the early stages here. For the mana pool, as far as like mana pool, if you don't have enough mana to throw out your ultimate, then you're like, shite. And that kind of harassment drops you so low where you do kind of question if you can get it done. And relying on bottle charges isn't enough. Because they can easily get cancelled during the fight, so you won't get your full regeneration out from it. So having something like stick charges is a lot better, but you just use those. Come with me. Trying to battle up against J4. He got the Malphus off, but Conversion Army is gone. He could potentially go for the Black Hole, but... Oh, no! No, 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 no! AA Blast is coming in right now. It's going to hit on all of them. The Chrono will go down, and they'll kill off Ogre Mishai. And then again, VS swaps him down, stuns into Ace, follow up some with the Ignite damage. They'll use the Voodoo Restoration to try and keep Ace alive, but at the same time, the damage coming out from Nexus is quite high. Magic Missile, he's got it off cooldown. I don't think he realized he actually had the stick charges available for that one. And two attacks all it will require. He can't reach Come With Me, then we can Come With Me. He turns around to get the Malphus Sun off and get his teammate out there out to safety. Let's say bold and daring on one side of it and calm calculation on the other. Come With Me will manage to escape from that one. Queen of Pain also dying a long way from home. Back behind the tier 2 tower that ended up happening. And Ice Blast trying to catch out. I don't even throw that. Thought he'd be going for Come With Me. The level 1 Ice Blast wouldn't be enough to kill him, I don't think. Not unless the blast itself really hit. Just the chill effect wouldn't be enough. At least. So Hardy's now here on the bottom lane.
Dire's top tower
as the lane switching continues, playing musical lanes right now. Snatched from the jaws of but Hani, he's a lot better to be down here on the bottom lane. A ranged damager up against a Razor. Also over that leap means you're going to break that link a lot earlier. He's got a lot more farm on him than most of the other heroes on his team. And the Corp is the only one with a higher net worth. Now top lane, Nexus. It's no chrono, so it's just up to time locks, and then with the bouncing casts done, right, lock in position long enough for the plants to field to connect. The ice blast is on the way, but it's just the extra support. Without a chrono, they really couldn't have gone for that. They don't have enough control. Wishot doesn't have an intimidating ultimate either. He's just short of his level 6. And now with the rotation up from Lone Druid, not only can they take the tier 2 tower, but they can go for more than this. The Ogre Magi has the potential to get a good multicast off. Why don't we have Razor pull back to buy? Also just a TP scroll in case he has to come back. In fact, there is going to TP coming in towards that mid lane. BJ4 ignites over on Calmy. Still no multicast. He's attempting for it. Now he's going to get Malibu stunned up. The tick out with the conversion damage. It's getting close to J4, but he's got 5 stick charges up his sleeve too, so they can't kill him off with this. The Shadow Strike damage is nice, but he even can hold on to his stick charge. It's not a problem at all. Bottom tower is under attack. Hey, he says Chrono or Varl, but Sharshlow is inside that ultimate form of his. And with that, the Faceless Void just doesn't have the damage required to get the kill. He's still trying to build into treads, let alone having a Mask of Madness to boot. Nexus is the man that's about to finish up his mech. 5 gold away and it can fly out in him. This means his bear's free to do whatever he wants, and the fact the bear's just mocking him. Walking around with a Mask of Madness of his own, of course, that is now possible because of the mana now that has been available to the bear. Being made available to the bear. So the bear attack's even faster, so no longer do you have to go, maybe I need that hyperstone of mine. Pull that bear back. Ace, he's gonna chrono up, but then you've got Ryze. The bear's gonna keep on attacking into him. No potential entangle to stop that ultimate of Ryze. Now she ended up working well for Ryze, the fact that he got entangled. Because without that, he couldn't have guaranteed himself he can get a full Death Ward duration off. So the Lone Druid will go down. I'm liking that Mask of Madness build. Really liking that Mask of Madness build. Dire's middle tower is under attack. Just makes the bear so much more effective in the early stages. Without having to buy something like a point booster to make it work. Now Nexus and J4. They're going to smoke up and rotate around to this bottom lane. They're searching for Hani. Push the advantage a little bit further. If they can get more, they'll go for it. Leave an aggressive observer ward down so they know no one's in the tree line. Their vision doesn't extend out to the lane. Not until the creepway pushes up. And J4. Well, there's no vision for Hani in here. So he'll be completely blind to this. The Ice Blast on the way in. He'll leap himself in, but he already got hit by the Ice Blast with the Ignite. The Wave of Terror to give the extra vision. And a simple execution from Power Rangers. Dire's bottom tower is under attack. This is exactly how Power Rangers prefer to play. Roaming, ganking, aggressive heroes. Of course, though, doesn't help them up against something like that. Arise knew she had the combination up and running, so just threw it. And in the bottom lane, well, Arise is in actually a little bit more trouble after Arise died in the middle lane. Ah, this team's going to be the bane of my tongue. Good trade-offs across the board now. But this tier 2 tower, Calmy just won't let it go. A Midnight Pulse will help to clean up a little bit. Radiant's middle, I guess she's going into a hand attack. Of Midas as this Enigma? Where's the mech for your team? Where's the supporting abilities? Where's the early game items? You're being pushed and attacked. This is a VS core, but damn it. This guy wants to fight early on. You even got a Razor walking around with a Vanguard. He's rushing a Crimson Guard for his line, for his team. So they're capable of being over-aggressive in the lineup. You got a Mask of Madness, Lone Druid Bear with 2.7k. Now Ace, Arise, he's gonna get entangled up. The Witch Doctor will throw the ulti out again and the arrow will connect, which will allow Arise to finish the job here over on Sharshlow. The VS swapping Ace away. The last attack will come in, but Ace had to commit so deep for that. The Ice Blast will fly in. But Arise dies on the river. So it's Lone Draw for a Quap and a Void, and you committed every single ultimate you had to that fight apart from Black Hole. Because Kaomi is too busy farming up in the jungle with a hand of Midas to lose all their tier 1 towers. I don't know what this Midas is meant to do. Dire's middle tower has fallen. Because it's not even going to skyrocket you into a bigger item. You want Blink, BKB, and Mech. That's kind of like the goal right now of the Enigma. But all of these don't really help you anyway. Like, the BKB doesn't help you because you've got the ability for VS to swap you out. And if the bear's not caught inside the black hole and he's on the other side of it, potentially the entangle could also pull you out of your black hole. Now, top lane, they're going to go for Kami. And because there's no mech, there's a guy with 5 armor. That magic missile took half of his life off him.
My goddess wished you dead.
I've got to ask, come with me, why you made this choice. Just so I can understand. Like, just, you think about the logic. Okay, if you're trying to rush your bigger items, what's it really going to give you? Like, the blink deck you would have had anyway shortly after, like, because the mice cost you a crap ton of money. So, if you're going to buy a hand of mice and you really just want to rush a blink dagger, then you just rush a blink dagger. You wouldn't use the mice to get yourself there. And looking for levels on the Enigma isn't really as effective. Because the black hole, normally you only keep it at level 1 anyway. Because it's just cheaper on the mana pool. Now, Ace going to leap himself away to safety. They've lost this tier 2 tower.
Dire structures are fortified.
You could potentially be trying to get yourself up in levels of the Midnight Pulse and using the mice to do that. But right now, he's using it on the creep wave in the mid. Now, the Ice Blast is coming in too. It's actually flying all the way down to bottom lane. They're searching for a Ryze. TP's on the way, and a Ryze is caught inside that with the Blast, the Ignite. He forced to TP himself out, and there's no follow-up stun. Even with one attack, it wouldn't be enough damage. But they do push him back off the tier 1 tower for now. And Power Rangers just rotate. That Crimson Guard is now up for Cheshire Cat. Deciding not to go for the mech for his team, because he already had the VS doing that. So both Crimson Guard as well as the mech to keep Power Rangers pushing earlier. The Midnight Pulse is definitely causing them some problems. And at the same time, Chrono as well as Death Ward being used to kill off J4, worth because they pick up the gem as well from that. But they're still losing out of map control. They're having another fun time with that bear. I gotta get... Ah, oh, they lost the bear. Shashlo will re-summon straight away though. And the tower actually gets knotted up by the Enigma conversions, but come with me in too close. And again, there's no survivability. No survivability whatsoever on this Enigma. Ends up being a trader for a tier 2 for a tier 1, but... with one and one hero change up as well, the advantage still goes the way of Power Rangers. And they're coming up, and they'll take the tier 2 tower in the bottom lane. It's just obvious what they're going to do. They can also... well, actually, they're going for Roshan. That courier, I think, got a glimpse of it, or at least can hear it. And the courier flies back over again. They know what's going on. A Maelstrom now appears for Lone Druid's Bear. They're looking for what? A courier snipe? Not much point going for that one. They've still got Roshan. Actually, that's in Lone Druid's hands. They give it to him, they give it to Cheshire Cat. I think it's better in... oh, yeah, they give it to Moon. He is obviously the more fragile of the heroes. That's right, they do drop him, they give it to him. So with Lone Druid, then you at least ensure that bear is... yeah. It's going to stay alive even if the hero goes down. Let's face this void. Chrono's coming off cooldown. Simple Ice Blast can push him back off this lane, though. And in fact, Ace is already backing up anyway, so no reason to waste the ultimate. Especially when you got a Razor rotating in. This Razor, regeneration not too shabby. Armor, not looking too bad either. They're trying to build everything to get up towards that high ground. The next part of it's going to be, well, one, the Agon Interceptor for Ouija set, because that needs to hit and give that consistent tick down over onto Fnatic, because the Voodoo Restoration doesn't do anything for you when you hit by that. In fact, he's going to throw a blast up towards the top lane. He's trying to slow Harney and the creep wave down. Rather successful with the life points, the range creeps, but didn't actually bring him down all the way. Radiance, so now we'll find ourselves in a trade-off again. Cheshire Cat, the Chrono, support, Wish Doctor, he's in the neighborhood. A Ryze as well, and the arrow will connect. So the Razor will go down, but that's a blood-lusted Lone Druid Bear. Pushing. Look at the size of this thing. It's getting bigger and bigger and bigger. Everyone gets bloodlusted, everyone gets buffed up, and this tower trade-off, it doesn't work for Power Rangers, for Fnatic. Like, it's a tier 2 for a tier 1 tower, but you've lost all your added towers, and you managed to bring down the tier 1 towers. There's your blink dagger for come with me, so it is still going to be the blink. He needs the perfect hole. That's what he needs right now. He needs to be the perfect hole, and then the Chrono follows up. The Midnight Pulse to start with. The bear will take a lot of damage from this, considering he's already got the Mask of Madness turned on. That's the risk of going the build like this. But the Ice Blast coming in, the Magic Missile. It'll be just joined by the Lethal Wave, but Ryze is still getting affected by that Ice Blast. and they beat the tower down again. The bear will take a hit. There is a resummon available for it, but they will lose this bear now. In fact, gonna be denied up by Shashlo himself. Turns on his own creature. But this tier 3 tower is now down to 442 life points of a 1600. Just shows you the full effectiveness of this lineup. They don't care if they lose a bear, everything is buffed. They just go high ground. And Enigma, well, there's your black hole, but the VS next was in perfect position for the swap back out. Even gets the stun over to Ryze, the Moonlight Shadow will buy some space as Ryze. Cheshire Cat is trying to do something about him, but he'll get the full death ward off. VS back to life though, and that full death ward actually did nothing. The lone druid bear is so injured. But at the same time, what's really left here? They come high ground, it's a full life points, vengeful spirit. The void will jump in, the chrono is up. And the damage into Cheshire Cat, they will be able to pick up the kill, the Ice Blast. On very minimal connection, only connects onto 8 in fact. And Shashlo backing himself up now. Power Rangers, they threw their life points into that Rax. Luckily for Shashlo, he was able to TP himself out and then recall the bear back. But they brought down the bottom tier 3 tower and the Ranger Rax down a half life. Fnatic still had a really good fight for that. They're going to get a lot of golden experience from it. Up by 4,000 in that experience engine, 2k in the gold, with 1,000 lost by PR. We're seeing a kick down. So there's going to be a lot of shared money coming in. Ryze with an Ogre Club can pick up the point booster and probably a set of wards or something along those lines. The Faceless Void has his Mask of Madness now. The Queen of Pain is on her way to a side device alongside the Orchid. So back into our farming stages now, 22 minutes in. And J4. All he's gotta do is just keep these lanes pressured out. Now come again. The Lone Druid bears back off cooldown. And with another 2.8k gold inside that Lone Druid, he needs a little bit more stability for this bear if he's gonna keep using the Mask of Madness. It's just so much amplified damage onto him. And he's attacking building, so he's not getting the lifesteal from that. Are we getting a Hyperstone? Orb of Venom drop? Yeah, it's a Hyperstone. We are just rapidly increasing this guy's attack speed. Fortifications available this time around from Fnatic, and look at the bear, just runs up to come with me. They'll find Ace in the corner, he's got Chrono available. The arrow connect on that bear is in a half life, and now the Void. Chrono is in. Harney, a long way up. The Plunderfield did some early damage. The Witch Doctor Rollman, Moses being tanked up by the Lone Druid, so only the Enigma is down so far. Nexus backing up, Orion's going to pick him up at the back end of play. But the Lone Druid Bear is still up, and they're killing off Fnatic heroes left, right, and center. Harney is being forced back. Shadow Strike or not, the paralyzing cast slowing them down. But the Bear getting Bloodlust up. There's your fortification finally being used. And they just keep that Ignite over on Harney so he can't come back into the fight again. He's trying to get close. So is Orion's, but the plasma field damage. Harney down to 8 life points. The Orca will go on Cheshire Cat, but they brought down the melee Rax. Now pushing in this bottom lane, they lost the Lone Druid, the Ice Blast, way too point blank. And this is just time to bail out. Ace chasing, looking for Ouija's Sick. He doesn't have mana for a TP scroll. The arrow's gonna fly in too. Actually, that must have gone a different direction, searching for a kill over on Cheshire, but it won't happen. But they'll get the kill over on Ouija's Sick. Or will they? Nope. TP's out in time. So overall, gold experience rather even across them, but they got the bigger thing. The melee Rax has gone the bottom lane, which means now all Power Rangers have to do is keep the pressure on the top lane. And this will split the lineup for Fnatic. Fnatic, when they play this, they've just got to force this bottom lane out as far as they possibly can, hit to the tier 2 tower if they potentially can do that, and then come back at the right time to fight. It's going to be like their only objectives right now. Yeah, see him actually trying to bring out more TP scrolls to the lineup. The Radiant side, well, they're very much aware of what's going on. They leave Observer and Sentry inside the base. Sentry on top of the hill, and another Observer here too. So they're watching all the movements out of the bottom lane. They know what they're up against. In fact, even a multicast of the Ignite, they just can't catch a break on this mid lane. Just burns it all down. And this ogre's getting pretty close. He can pick up his point boost from an ogre club, make himself a lot tanky. But he's actually gonna go for a blink dagger. So it seems all about the initiation from this ogre now. He is rather tanky, even with just arcane boots and magic wand. He's still rather tanky. Blink dagger. Yep, there she is. Just needs that opening. And needs to make it for Nexus. Because if Nexus can still survive through these fights, they get such a big damage boost. He's already pumping out a lot of deeps as it is. And Razor, with only 600 gold to go to his Aghanim Scepter. With the Crimson Guard as well. Is that the Void popping a Chrono? No, it was the Bear again, I assume. Nope. I'm just hearing crap. It's just a time walk from Ace. Come with me. Dude. Ooh. He is so lucky he doesn't get attacked once. Now that blink dagger put on cooldown. He's living life so far on the edge, it's not funny. But this push is now going to come on top lane. Cheshire Cat's given enough momentum to the bottom lane that it'll take care of the rest. Even then, they're still got fortification for their tier 2 towers. And again, it's a tier 2 tower for a tier 3. You'll take that trade any day. The only thing you can be really sad about is the fact that Razor does not have his Aghanim Scepter. He can farm up the mid creep wave for the moment. And I got a funny feeling he wants to actually Aghanim's farm on top of the Ancients. If you can time this right, he's only going to be 50 gold away now. Take the next creep wave, plaster field it up, get your Aghanims out there. He'll need to bring a Clarity out with him though, because he's pretty damn short of mana. Are they TPing back? Yeah, they're TPing back. Must be looking for a kill first then. Roshan is up pretty soon. In fact, he's already up. Might be another reason to TP back. Alright, Aghanims is done for Cheshire Cat. Courier though is halfway up the lane. So he's going to need some time for this. Again, Harney trying to keep this split push going. 15-13. The net worth. So close right now. And the experience is still up. But when your Amelia racks up and you got a lineup like Power Rangers does, you don't care about net worth and gold advantage right now. You care about staying alive during the team fights, which allow you to bring down the buildings. That's the goal. That's the plan, Stan. I'm gonna smoke and see if they can find an opening. Either that or they go in. They're going for Roshan. Leave the reach. Ooh, ward, nothing around. Actually, yeah, there is. It's not gonna be scouted out. The wave of terror, though, that flagged to Ace. And he's actually gonna smoke up with this Chrono. They're really quick at this. So quick, they're already done. By the time the Fnatic even slightly realized what was going on, man, they hit hard. So I love this Ogre and Bear combination from Power Rangers. It's so powerful. And with the Aghanim Scepter from Razor, and Aegis the Immortal now is into the hands of Nexus again. So the VS will survive to fight, and will always get their mech off during the games. They're going to try and breach into the Tier 3 tower. And all Nexus needs to do is just wait out for a moment to make sure he can stop that black hole from come with me. They do have more stuns though. So even then, all you really have to do is just have like Nexus here, and then you have the Ogre Magi over here. At which point, no chance of a perfect hold. It'll get cancelled straight away. Because you've also got that blink dagger, so the Ogre can hold back because of that. Positioning wise, he'll always be in the right spot. Just stay in the trees and wait for the Enigma. With the Observer Ward up on the high ground too. The tower. The bear! Someone stop him! But they don't know where to stop. Cheshire Cat's pushing with his Aghanim Scepter. They do still have fortification, but they took the damage instead of using the fortification. Radiant's top tower is under attack. And the bear will just come in and do the same thing again. And the bottom lane is bringing its army in. This will finish up the range racks because they'll keep their attention so far. That's the reason why you're seeing the Queen of Pain being so over-aggressive. Dire's middle tower is under attack. Now the arrow, tanked by the range creep. Cheshire Cat not looking too great on mana. There's some arcane boots around here. Well, they got one over on the Ogre Magi. Buffs up the bear again. With the bottom lane in. Yeah, there goes your range racks. The bear just wants to move up and take it. That's all he wants to do. He's got a resummon on the bear, so there's no real problem for this. And he keeps intercepting the creep waves too. So every single time that PR creep wave arrives, it arrives at full life. Alright, now they come up. Fortification. It's gonna be used if they wanna hold this top tower. And now, there's your stun. Multicast three times over. The Ice Blast hits from the Ancient Apparition, gets the kill. They still haven't brought down this tower yet. The bear should die here. In fact, it does do so, but Sharshlo, he doesn't care. He's gonna resummon. They brought down the tier 3 tower in the mid and the top now. So while these towers might go down, and they got the Queen of Pain too, all the advantage goes their way. It's tier 3 tower. Okay, come on. It's so low. 100 life points. Bear comes back up. Two swings. Three swings. Try to do a denial. Bouncing cast just keeps going. But then a multicast to get over onto this bear. It just wants to battle while in the middle lane. Ace with the Moonlight Shadow was coming in very, very close. The buyback actually coming out from the Queen of Pain. And they can back up. The BKB is now up and running for the Enigma. So there's only one person that can cancel out his ultimate, and that's the VS. So now it's up to Nexus. But he's got a level 2 ultimate. Look at the range on this ultimate of his. It's easy, easy swapping. And they've got Ace. There's your swap up already. Yes, he swapped himself in. Wish Dr. Aldi will take it, will go down as well. And this will be the death of the Razor and the VS. A quick stun to Harney, but the bear just comes in. Come with me. We'll get this black hole off. At the same time, the bear is still beating into Ryze, killing him off. And there's just no follow-up. They've already triggered everything they've got. Ryze blinks himself away to safety. They buff up onto the top of the lone druid. He's out of bears, however. But Nexus back to the world of the living. It's the reason why he's happy to swap himself in. The Void Ball back. The range ranks being chipped away. The top lane is pushing in again, too. And the Enigma and the Wish Doctor is down. All their combos are down. And that's the reason why Nexus is so happy to stand here and try and fight at a right. Where's that magic missile? And the Ice Blast that connects also over on Ace. Nexus could try and stand his ground here. And he will. The Moonlight Shadow down. The Starfall damage is a little bit too much. He's trying to chase down that last hero kill over on the face of this Void. But they just rotate towards top lane. Cheshire Cat's ulti will do the work. They swap in Harney. Leaps away, the magic missile will go. He's got no way out of this one. J4 blinks after him just to beat him down with his club. And Ryze will also try and stand his ground up against J4. Malediction damage is there. And they call the GG. This game is over. Their base has most certainly been ravaged, even in the absence of a Tidehunter. And the victory will go the way of Power Rangers, giving us a draw for our game. And keeping Power Rangers' hopes alive in the tournament. Not crushing Fnatic's just yet. They'll go 4-6 at the end of this one, but Power Rangers will wrap up the tournament 7-7 at the same score as Cloud9. There's one team that can push in front of them now, and that is Na'Vi. Na'Vi still have their game to be played up against Virtus Pro. The date yet to be scheduled has got delayed as Na'Vi have traveled down to China to play in the WCA. And when they come back, they'll play that game. The Alliance, they've still got a couple of games to go as well. And they're going to find themselves in a position where if they can win their final remaining games as well, of course, that is up against Fnatic, as well as my other one, which is not listed here for some reason. No, there it is, up against Virtus Pro. So they're the two remaining games. If they get a 4-0 win on that one, they tie with Cloud9 and guarantee themselves a spot in the playoffs. I say guarantee. Anything is still possible with Fnatic and VP on the Rampage. If you can all have everyone on 7-7-7, it's going to be crazy. All right. In the meantime, thanks for watching, everyone. We'll have our VODs uploaded very shortly to our Dailymotion channel. And you can also check out Capitalist. He's casting the ISO Cup tonight over on joinDOTA Red. So please head yourself over there to joinDOTA Red. You'll find the live stream link over on joinDOTA.com. And of course, you can find all the details for the competitions over there as well. Follow the coverage pages. They have all the information you are searching for. So thanks for watching, everyone. And I'll see you next time on the live stream.